Hello, everyone. Today's devotional reading will be from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 33 through 37, where it is written, "Again, you have heard that it was said to those of ancient times, 'You shall not swear falsely, but carry out the vows you have made to the Lord.' But I say to you, do not swear at all, either by heaven, for it is the throne of God, or by the earth, for it is his footstool, or by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. And don't swear by your head, for you cannot make one hair white or black. Let your word be yes, yes, or no, no. Anything more than this comes from the evil one." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. In my first year at seminary, they had us buy a business ethics book called The Speed of Trust. And the professor said, "This may sound very strange. This is a seminary, not an MBA course." But he said, "I'll tell you right now, trust is the most valuable commodity in the world. You have all the time, all the money. If you don't trust someone, they don't trust you, you'll never get anything done. And if you do, someone will find a way to sabotage it because they think you're coming after them or they're coming after you. Self-sabotage is the worst of all. You could have done anything. People didn't want it. How do you avoid this? The only way you can avoid it? Trust." He was absolutely right. And that's what brings me to the scripture message for today. He says, do not swear. Not going, use foul language. He says, "I swear by the head, my head, that I will pay you back your..." Or, "I swear by the gold of the altar, the gift on the altar," that in this culture, people would swear by themselves, by their family, by the temple, and so on. And the more spiritual it got, the more powerful that oath was supposed to be. And Jesus cuts the heart of it. Maybe you're a con artist. Maybe you're lying to yourself. The point is you're being dishonest. You want something. And through dishonesty, "I swear by the temple, I swear by the city of Jerusalem, I swear by my daughter, I swear by my..." Fill in the blank. It's words. I can swear by all... People swear by all kinds of things and don't mean it. Why? Because they want something. You're lying to yourself. You're lying to someone else. You can't build trust. Therefore, life, for you, it's like trying to canoe with one paddle. It ain't going anywhere. Correction, rowboat. Can't row it with one paddle. Our Lord put us on this earth for a reason. We need to cooperate and get that reason accomplished. Which we can't do if we're, "I swear by this, I swear by that." We can't do this if we're not honest with each other. And that's what Jesus speaks here concerning oaths. Don't bluff people with an oath saying, "I swear by enough holy things, you'll believe me. If not, oh well." Let your yes be yes. Let your no be no. And that's it. That's honesty. That is how you get trust. And that is how things can get done. None of this fancy hocus pocus stuff. That's dishonesty. That's lying. That's a waste. And disrespects God, by the way. "I swear by the temple, I swear by the thing on the altar, I swear by the church in our modern world." Does this church, this temple, and so on mean nothing? It's just an excuse for you to invoke to get what you want? Yeah, not something that pleases God. He's worth more than that. So don't get caught in the trap. "If I swear by enough things, I'm automatically correct." Be a straight shooter. Yes, yes, no, no. And don't worry about it. Let us close with prayer. Lord, help us to honor your teaching here and be honest with each other and not fool each other with all kinds of oaths. Amen.